The opposition legislators allege that government security agencies have continued to arrest political opponents under the watch of the president, with no serious action taken against the perpetrators. They also accuse government of failure to fight corruption and violation of the rights of citizens.
We feel that he is addressing us illegitimately for as long as he holds political prisoners, especially those from the opposition, unlawfully in known and unknown places of detention, in gazetted and ungazetted places of detention. We believe and know, like many other right-thinking members of our society do, that Mr. Museveni is detaining those people as prisoners of conscience.
President Museveni is expected to address Parliament tomorrow at Kololo, but the agenda of his address is not yet known. Some opposition legislators noted that they have found no value in a one-sided address.
Parliament has opposers and proposers. In Parliament, there must be a debate. That is why we have opposers and proposers. If the president wants to be listened to in silence, he should call for a cabinet meeting.
Whenever I get the opportunity to watch the president, it's as if he's reading a will. The president knows what we are going through, knows what the country faces. We want actions. Actually, we would be very, very happy if the president kept a yama in us talking, but taking action on the different things that challenge a common man.
During today's afternoon sitting at Parliament, members of the opposition registered their reservations for the Kololo address, questioning the essence of COVID-19 testing requirements at a time when COVID-19 is no longer a public threat. Some opposed the location of the address, wondering why it did not take place at Parliament.
Without even giving due consideration to other options like face masking, social distance, and you know, the president sits extremely far from the members. Madam Speaker, I would seek your indulgence to allow members, like there are some members who may arrive tomorrow and may not have sufficient ample time on their hands to go for that test.
I want to seek clarification from you on our behalf whether you have been privy to the president's results so that equally we do not get infected.
Honorable Segona, we are going to have everybody tested, including the president himself. And if you will be positive, he will not come. He won't come.
However, the Minister for ICT, Dr. Chris Bariomosi, has hit back at the opposition, saying their boycott can't be felt in the NRM-dominated house. He has advised them to attend via Zoom if they find Kololo inconveniencing.
And sit in the parliament when we sit. And you have seen the parliament is never full. Members have sent themselves. But as long as there is a reasonable number to constitute those to sit, then the parliament sits. So whether the opposition comes or not, it does not matter. Secondly, we amended our rules of procedure to provide for attendance through Zoom using a digital platform. So you may not physically be in the house, but you can follow the proceedings through Zoom.
Museveni's address comes at a time of the height of the iron sheet scandal and anti-homosexuality debate, which has escalated anxiety of members of parliament. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.